Good evening, I'm Alex Hazard, and this is Made in Northern New York. One thing that's made in Northern New York are kids. Lots and lots of kids, and we want to keep them healthy and the world they're living in healthy as well. Tonight, that's what our special's all about. Later, we explore how one local school's getting kids to think about food differently. And we talk to a local organization about how they're keeping the environment healthy and teaching kids to keep it healthy too. And right now, a story about how some local kids found a unique way to stay active in a year where that's been difficult.
For over 5,000 years, yoga's been used as a health benefit for people of all ages, from when it originated in ancient India. Sometime in the 90s, aerial yoga, a form of yoga where you're suspended from a ceiling, was introduced to Western culture. Not long after, it trickled into small towns around the country and eventually even into smaller areas like ours and local yoga studios like Vigilante right here in Watertown.
Aerial yoga is a hybrid type of yoga. We mix traditional yoga, some of the poses you would see on the mat, with a little bit of trapeze, a little bit of gymnastics. It's a combination, a good strength training. It's definitely a hybrid exercise.
A hybrid exercise with tricks and flips in the air would be sure to scare your parents a bit. So, you know, not much time passed before kids wanted up in the swing.
There you go, nice. We've been doing the kids' classes over 4 years.
We went to one of those classes offered to see if we could keep up.
Just hang there and breathe through it, man.
Hey, everybody.
Hey, Alex.
Is it all right if I interrupt your class here?
Sure.
All right,
come on
here
in.
We go.
Contrary to a loud entrance met with laughter, each class starts with quiet time.
Mentally, a lot of things. We start and end every class with Shavasana, so they have some quiet time, 2-3 minutes on the mat, where we just try to block out the outside world, just listen to quiet music, you know, bird sounds and whatnot. And usually by the end of class, like, we've forgotten everything else is going on outside these doors.
A practice welcomed by parents for their kids.
Really getting yoga where you have to kind of be calm, kind of relax, focus.
Especially after a year within the pandemic.
Especially the last year, it's been really good for the kids to come out and see some other people their age and have some interaction.
Socialization in a year where that's become more important for kids than ever.
I love getting her into anything we can do. A lot of her friends are into sports. She's a dancer. She just started playing soccer. And I thought aerial yoga, she would really pick up on it quickly because she's a dancer and she's super flexible, and she did. And it's with COVID and everything, it's just one thing they can still do and be active. And it's just really awesome that we have it.
Reagan is Joelle's daughter and a student in the class. She says her family is not the only one grateful for this unique opportunity.
My friends, they enjoy it too. Like, they like the stretch and having all this fun. Just like, we get to talk, and when you come in here, you just forget about everything.
Something I had trouble forgetting when I went into the studio, though, was singer Pink's 2010 Grammy performance, where she introduced a lot of the world to aerial yoga, where she sang suspended from the ceiling.
Did you see in the Grammys when Pink was spinning from the ceiling? Was there any inspiration there? That's what inspired me to come today, I have to tell you.
Forgetting that Reagan wasn't old enough to have seen that performance and remembered it, the idea that Pink represented of using aerial yoga to cross-train into other activities is alive, even here in Watertown.
In this particular studio, our aerial yoga is definitely a cross training. It's in a lot of fast movements, and I think that's the appeal with the kids. They like to spin around, they like to flip upside down, do their somersaults, and they like to pose and take pictures too.
Reagan uses it to cross train into dancing.
I like the exercise because I am a dancer, and that's kind of good for that.
Alexandra, a friend of Reagan's, uses it to cross train into dancing too, and something else.
Do hip hop and horse riding.
Ultimately, this yoga is used as a strength training, both mentally picturing the pose and physically pulling yourself into the pose.
Kids love it. They really do. They like the tricks and flips and all the stunts we do. I mean, it's great for flexibility, but it's also strength training. A lot of these kids are a lot stronger than they really think, you know, when they walk in the door, so they love doing all the flips and the fun, tricky stuff.
Both strengths that I could use some work on.
Push those knees through. Push them through. Keep going. You're almost there. Nice. Good job.
Oh my God.
For more information on vigilante yoga or unique activities like these going on in the North Country, go to informnny.com.
After the break, how kids are saving the river. And later, how one school's going from having a cafeteria to practically having a farm-to-table restaurant.